after studying this module, you shall be able to know about industrial water pollution, which industries are the major polluting ones, learn about the waste generated by various industries, identify the standards set by Central Pollution Control Board, CPCB India, for the discharge of waste in water bodies. The Industrial Revolution has brought about significant progress in all spheres of life, including manufacturing processes, which have become more productive and efficient. But this is true that nothing comes without any price. The advancement in industrial technologies, accompanied with untreated discharge of wastewater, introduced challenge of excessive water pollution. Industries are known to be the largest sources of water pollution, responsible for more than 50% of the total water pollution. Water gets polluted by discharging wastewater or effluent into streams, lakes, or oceans. The commonly known water pollutants are grit, asbestos, phosphates, nitrates, mercury, lead, caustic soda, and other sodium compounds, sulfuric acid, and petrochemicals, etc. In addition to this, there are a number of manufacturing plants discharging undiluted corrosives, poisons, and other obnoxious byproducts resulting in water pollution. For example, the construction industry discharges slurries of gypsum, cement, abrasives, metals, and poisonous solvents. Polychlorinated biphenyl compounds, components of lubricants, plastic wrappers, and adhesives are other groups of contaminants that enter into food chains and cause toxicity. Also, the wastewater at high temperature is discharged by thermal power plants, and this results in thermal pollution by increasing the temperature of water bodies. Such an increase of water temperature decreases the dissolved oxygen of the water bodies, thereby disrupting the water's ecological balance, killing some plant and animal species while encouraging the overgrowth of others. The Ministry of Environment and Forests has identified 17 most polluting industries. The discussion of every industry is beyond the scope of this module, and we will discuss a few representative cases and water pollution caused by this. The Central Pollution Control Board of India has identified 17 industries which are causing water pollution. These industries are shown here. They include distillery, including fermentation, the sugar industry, fertilizer industry, pulp and paper industry, chloralkali, pharmaceuticals, dyes and dye intermediates, pesticides, oil refineries, tanneries, petrochemicals, which manufacture and not only merely use raw materials, the cement industry, thermal power plants, iron and steel industry, and zinc smelter, copper smelter, and aluminium smelter. Discussing all these industries is beyond the scope of the module, so we restrict ourselves to a few of them. Paper and pulp industry. Paper refers to the sheet of material made by felting the vegetable cellulose fibers together. These fibers are present in almost all types of plant materials. Firstly, the fibers are converted into pulp. After that, the material is further treated with chemicals. The role of the chemicals is to serve strength, coating, and impregnations to pulp materials. Therefore, large amounts of natural resources and energy is required for the paper production in the paper industry. Paper and pulp industries are known to be India's oldest industrial sector. Paper is socio-economically important because it is directly related to the industrial as well as economic growth of the country. Although paper is used for many purposes, but it is most important in modern civilization as it is used to record knowledge. Paper manufacturing is highly energetic and water intensive industry. The production of paper is a highly polluting process, and therefore there is need of potential control equipment. It is estimated that in India, approximately 905.8 million meter cubed of water is consumed and 695.7 million meter cubed of wastewater is discharged annually by the paper and pulp industry. India's average water consumption is approximately 150 meter cubed per ton. That is far above the global best specific water consumption of 28.66 meter cubed per ton. The large gap is primarily attributed to the use of out-of-date technology and equipments and poor water management practices. The high percentage of water requirements for Indian paper and pulp industries lead to lowering of the groundwater table and thus increased pumping costs and, more importantly, water shortage in many regions. Realizing the damage due to water loss by excessive usages of water in paper manufacturing, Central Pollution Control Board, CPCB, has taken initiative to develop the water conservation guidelines and water consumption standards and entrusted National Productivity Council to undertake the study to address these issues. As per the figures of 2003-04, India produces 5.96 million tons of paper per year through 309 paper manufacturing mills at a capacity utilization of approximately 60%. The paper manufacturing mills has increased from just 17 in 1951 to around 600 in 2002. Still, since 2001-02, the population of paper mills have fallen sharply to 309 in the year 2004. This is due to increased environmental regulatory pressure and water shortage. Paper products can generally be classified into four major categories: fine papers, coarse papers, tissues and specialties papers. Examples of fine papers are bond, book, mimeo, printing, writing and white papers. Coarse papers include newsprint, common wrapping and container boards, as well as building products. Tissues include most of the widely used thin papers such as utility tissues and special wrapping papers. A few of the almost innumerable specialty papers are electrical insulating, cigarette, photographic, card stocks, etc. The waste generated from paper and pulp industry arises due to the processes. Water is needed for grinding wood, as a carrying agent in chemical pulping and bleaching. It is needed to bring chemicals and heat into contact with the raw material. It is used as a pulp washing agent and as a furnish carrier in the paper machine system in wood preparation. It is employed as a conveying and washing agent and for hydraulic debarking. The discharge of spent water from pulp and paper making introduces two broad categories of pollutants: suspended matter and dissolved organic substances into the natural aquatic systems. The suspended matter is in the form of wood particulates, fiber debris, filling and coating materials, which form the bottom deposits in receiving streams and are inimical to aquatic life. They are unsightly and on decomposition produce odoriferous components. They also make the stream opalescent, due to which the penetration of sunlight into the water decreases appreciably. There is decreased photosynthesis, and as a result, the DO levels fall, which adversely affects the aquatic life forms. These pollutants are slowly acted upon by microorganisms and are transformed into simple, harmless, inorganic compounds. In this degradation process, they deplete the DO of the water to a great extent, and therefore, aquatic organisms are choked to death. The dissolved polysaccharide and proteins stimulate the growth of slime organisms, causing biological imbalance. Lignins and tannins cause discoloration and impart an anesthetic appearance. Now we come to the agrochemical industry, mainly dealing with pesticides and fertilizers. The increasing human population and urbanization has made it necessary to improve the quality and quantity of food. Thus, the use of pesticides, fertilizers, and manures in agriculture is increasing day by day. Pesticides are chemically composed to kill or control pests. In agriculture, some of the known pesticides are herbicides, insecticides, fungicides, nematicides, and rodenticides, known to control weeds, insects, fungi, nematodes, and vertebrate respectively. The fertilizers and manures increase the soil fertility and provide essential nutrients to the plants. Their function is to restore the soil nutrients removed by the crop. Pesticides. Pesticides are the substances intended for use as plant growth regulators, defoliants, desiccants, fruit thinning agents, or sprouting inhibitors, and substances applied to the crops either before or after harvest in order to protect the crops during storage and transport. The main types of pesticides are insecticides, which prevent, destroy, or kill insects, organochlorine compounds like DDT, aldrin, dieldrin come under this category, as well as organophosphates and carbamates. Then we have fungicides that prevent, destroy, or inhibit the growth of fungi. And the main fungicides used are thiobenzidol, carboxin, craptan, and organomercury compounds. Herbicides are substances that kill unwanted plants like weed. We have diquat, bromacil, 2,4-diuron, etc. in this category. And rodenticides prevent, inhibit, or kill rodents like warfarin, diphenthion, etc. The toxicity of a pesticide is its capacity or ability to cause injury or illness. The toxicity of a particular pesticide is determined by subjecting test animals to varying dosages of the active ingredient. Active ingredient is a chemical component of the pesticide product that controls pests. Toxicity is of two kinds, acute and chronic. Acute toxicity is basically the ability of a substance to cause harmful effects rapidly. That is within a short span of time of exposure. Could be a few hours or a day of absorption. On the other hand, chronic toxicity is the ability of a substance to cause adverse health effects resulting from long-term exposure to a substance. The toxicity of a pesticide can be measured in several ways, but generally, human toxicity is estimated based on test results on rats and other animals. The poisoning intensity of pesticides vary from rats to people and other animals. LD50 or lethal dose 50 is the dose of a pesticide that will kill half of a group of test animals from a single exposure by either dermal, oral, or inhalation routes. The larger an animal, the greater is the lethal dose required to kill it. The LD50 is expressed in milligrams per kilogram of body weight of the test animal. For example, if a pesticide has an oral LD50 value of 10 mg per kg and the test animals each weigh 1 kg, 50% of the animals would die of poisoning if each ate 10 mg of the pesticide. LC50 or lethal concentration 50 value is a measure of the toxicity of a pesticide when test animals breathe air mixed with pesticide dust, vapors, or spray mist. The LC50 is the concentration of pesticide which is lethal to 50% of a population of test animals and is usually determined for a specific exposure period, for example, inhalation for 4 hours. The relative toxicity of pesticides is given in the table, and pathways of pesticides and associated health hazards are also shown. On this basis, pesticides are classified into groups of low, moderate, and high acute toxicity. For example, if a pesticide has a high or very acute toxicity, then the oral LD50 is less than 50 mg per kg and the dermal LD50 is less than 200 mg per kg. If the acute toxicity is moderate, the oral LD50 varies from 50 to 500 mg per kg and the dermal LD50 varies from 200 to 1000 mg per kg. And for a slow or slight acute toxicity, oral LD50 is over 500 mg per kg and the dermal LD50 is over 1000 mg per kg. The table shows source of pesticide entry into water and water source type which is predominantly affected. The entry source could be diffuse, that is through spray drift, volatilization, precipitation, surface runoff, overland flow, leaching, thorough flow, interflow, drain flow, and base flow seepage. It could be point arising due to tank filling, spillage, faulty equipment, washings and waste disposal, sumps, soakways and drainage, direct entry including overspray and consented discharges. In both cases, mostly all types of water bodies, including ditches, streams, ponds, river, etc., get affected. For point source, groundwater and surface water both get affected. The health hazards of pesticides are summarized in this table. DDT is a very common pesticide, which is effective against wide variety of insects, and it causes chronic liver damage, cirrhosis, hepatitis, endocrine reproductive disorders, and even cancer. Endosulfan is a broad spectrum, non-systemic contact and stomach insecticide, and it affects kidneys. What is most dangerous, the developing fetus, as well as causes liver problems, testicular and prostate cancer. Aldrin is effective against wireworms and termites and causes lung cancer and liver diseases. Dieldrin is used against ectoparasites such as blowflies, ticks, lice. It is widely employed in cattle and sheep dips and is also used to protect fabrics from moths, beetles, and against carrot and cabbage root flies. It causes liver diseases, Parkinson's and Alzheimer's disease. Heptachlor controls and inhibiting pests and causes reproductive and blood disorders. Clordane is a contact stomach and respiratory poison suitable for the control of soil pests and termites. It again causes reproductive and blood disorders, brain cancers and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Lindane is used against sucking and biting pests. It is used as a smoke to control pests and also used as a dust to control soil pests and causes chronic liver damage, cirrhosis, hepatitis, reproductive disorders, allergy, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, etc. Phenytrothione is a broad-spectrum contact insecticide used for control of chewing and sucking pests, and it causes, among other disorders, adverse eye effect. Fenthion is a persistent contact insecticide valuable against fruit flies, leafhoppers, cereal bugs, and weave birds in the tropics, and may be mutagenic in nature. Parathion, again a contact insecticide, is effective against soil insects with high mammalian toxicity, and it may be carcinogenic in nature. Prophenophos is used for control of important cotton and vegetable pests. It causes inhibition of and associated neurological and neuromuscular effects. Forate is a systemic and contact insecticides employed for the control of aphids, carrot fly, fruit fly, and wireworm in potatoes, and it causes neurological and neuromuscular effects. Malathion is a widely used insecticide, and its malathion and its oxygen analog meloxin are carcinogenic have been linked with increased incidence of leukemia in mammals. Monocrotophos, a powerful contact and systemic insecticide, which is used to control pests on crops like cotton, rice, soybean, maize, coffee, and potatoes, causes delayed neuropathy. Dimethoate, again a systemic and contact insecticide and acaricide, is effective against specific insects, and it may have carcinogenicity, birth defects, reproductive toxicity, and mutagenic effects. Chloropyrifos is a broad-spectrum insecticide used against mosquitoes, fly larvae, and other types of insects. It causes chronic neurobehavioral effects like persistent headache, blurred vision, unusual fatigue, muscular weakness, memory lapses, concentration, depression, and irritability. Diazinon is a contact insecticide which causes non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Quinalfos is a broad-spectrum contact and systemic insecticide which again has adverse effect of anticholinesterase. The same effect is noted in triazophos, used against flies and insect pests of cereals. Ethion, used for the control of aphids and mites, causes impaired memory and concentration disorientation, severe depression, irritability, headache, nightmares, and other neurological disorders. Acephate is a systemic insecticide effective against chewing and sucking pests and is a possible human carcinogen. Fenvalerate is a contact and stomach poison, and its adverse effect causes reduction in weight. Permethrin, a stomach and contact insecticide effective against broad range of pests, causes genetic damage, is a potential carcinogen, and also causes neurotoxic dangers to unborn children and threat to marine life. Cypermethrin is a stomach and contact insecticide effective against broad range of pests and is a possible human carcinogen. Delamethrin is a potent insecticide and is an endocrine disruptor. Carbaryl is a contact insecticide and fruit thinner with a broad spectrum of activity, effective against many pests of fruits, vegetable, and cotton. It may cause mutations, that is, genetic changes in living cells, a possible tetragen, and may damage the kidneys and the nervous system. Carbofuran, a broad-spectrum systemic insecticide and nematicide, causes inhibition of in humans and animals and affects nervous system function. Aldicab is a systemic insecticide and a nematicide which is formulated as granules for soil incorporation and is effective for control of aphids, nematodes, flea beetles, leaf miners, and white flies. And it can result in a variety of symptoms including weakness, blurred vision, headache, nausea, sweating, and tremors. Methonyl, used as a soil and systemic insecticide, causes inhibition of choline strays and resulting in flu-like symptoms. 2,4-D is a selective systemic post-emergence herbicide and causes twofold excess of all cancers. It was noted in Swedish railway workers, and it also causes non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Butachlore controls annual grasses and broad-leaved weeds. It causes weight loss, weight changes in internal organs, reduced brain size together with lesions. Paraquat is used as a plant desiccant effective against grasses, and the adverse effects include Parkinson's and Alzheimer's disease. Cimrazine and atrazine are soil-acting herbicides and they cause the cancer of testes. Glyphosate is a non-selective post-emergence herbicide. Adverse effects are not known. Isoproturon is used to control annual grass weeds in wheat, rye, and barley and appears to be a tumor promoter. Trifluralin is used to control annual grasses and broad-leaved weeds, and a prolonged or repeated skin contact may cause allergic dermatitis, and other effects include decreased RBC counts, an increase in methemoglobin, total serum lipids, triglycerides, and so on. Mancozeb is a protective fungicide effective against a wide range of foliage diseases, and it is toxic to humans. Captan is a foliage fungicide which could be a possible carcinogen and mutagen. Captopril is a protective wide spectrum foliage and soil fungicide and has carcinogenic potential. Carbendazin is a systemic fungicide which disrupts the production of sperm and damages testicular development in adult rats. Thus, we find that most pesticides are toxic in nature and they should be used with caution. Coming to fertilizers, commercial agricultural fertilizers generally contain one or more of the main plant nutrients, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. They are classified into three broad types depending upon which primary nutrient is supplied to the soil. Some examples of fertilizers are given in this table. Nitrogen-based fertilizers include sodium nitrate, ammonium nitrate, and urea. Phosphorus-based fertilizers include superphosphate, triple superphosphate, and potassium-based fertilizers are potassium chloride and potassium sulfate. Extensive use of fertilizers is detrimental to the living environment. The lost fertilizers follow different pathways depending upon their chemical state after transformation. It is washed away from the surface soil as surface runoff. It moves into soil beyond the rooting zone. This is noted mainly in case of nitrates, and contaminate the ground and surface water. Now we summarize what we have studied up to now. The largest single user of water is the industrial sector, which accounts for 50% of the daily water requirement. Treatment of industrial wastewaters gets complicated by the presence of a wide variety of inorganic and synthetic organic pollutants, many of which are not readily susceptible to biodegradation. Some industries recycle a large proportion of their water needs, especially water used for cooling. One large petrochemical plant uses 1.5 billion gallons of water per day, of which only 10% is new water, the rest is all recycled. The paper and pulp industry is the fifth largest consumer of energy by using approximately 4% of the entire world's energy.